Hi friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Journey with Vijay Kumar Shrivastav. Today I am going to present the title Tillage Implements. Before presentation, little introduction about myself. I am Vijay Kumar Shrivastav. I have done M.Sc. agriculture with specialization in agronomy from JP Pant University of Agriculture and Technology, Pantnagar in 1996, and presently working as a seed professional in one of the M.Sc. associated with seeds and pesticide group. So let's move to the presentation. Tillage implements. Any device used to carry on some soil work is called as implement. Implements are operated by animal power or by machinery. Implements are classified into three categories. First one is primary, second is secondary implements, and third is intercultural implements, depending on the purpose for which it is being used. Now to study about primary tillage implements. Primary tillage is the deepest operations performed during the period between two crops. The following are the implements which are used as a primary tillage. First one is country plow or wooden plow or desi plow. The indigenous plow consists of a wooden body to which a handle and a shaft pole are attached. The body is made of a bent piece of hardwood with two arms, making an angle of about 135 degree. It is given a wedge shape with an isosceles triangular section. A small piece of flat iron serves as a piercing point of the plow and is fixed over the plow body with clamps. The shaft pole is secured with the yoke during working. The working of plow results in the opening of V-shaped furrow. The width of furrow depends on the size of the plow bottom. The depth of the penetration of a country plow can be altered a little by pulling the implement behind or pushing forward, which results in deeper or shallow plowings respectively. It covers nearly 0.15 to 0.2 hectares area in 8 hours. Second primary tillage implement is improved iron plow. The bullock drawn improved iron plow is made of mild steel except the pole shaft, and hence it has longer life. As and when the shear wears off, it can be pushed forward. Pole shaft angles and height of the handle can be adjusted according to field requirements. The plow is provided with a mould bolt as optional attachment for soil inversion. This plow is suitable for dry plowing in all types of soil with a pair of bullocks, and it covers around 0.5 hectares area per day. Third primary tillage implement is boss plow. It is wooden plow with a mould bolt can shear instead of the usual small iron shear. It is used for the primary tillage operations in wetlands. Nowadays, this plow is made up of iron angles instead of woods to make it sturdy. It is also called as Melur plow in Tamil Nadu. Fourth primary tillage implement is mold bolt plow. It is a modern tillage implement used to plow deeply and pulverize the soil. It is more durable, easy to pull, and can be adjusted properly. The main parts of the mold bolt plow are the frog or body, handle, beam, shear, mold bolt, wheel, and coulter. This type of plow leaves no unplugged land as the furrow slices are cut clean and inverted to one side, resulting in better pulverization. The animal drawn mold bolt plow is a small plow to a depth of 15 cm. Big size tractor drawn mold bolt plow can plow up to a depth of 30 cm. Mold bolt plow are used when soil inversion is necessary. Victory plow is an animal drawn mold bolt plow with a short shaft. Fifth primary tillage implement is turn wrist plow. This is also called reversible plow. The mold bolt plow with shear is hinged either left or right side of the central body with a hook. When the mold bolt is needed to shift to another side, the hook is released and the mold bolt is easily swung to the opposite side. By this, when the plow reaches to one end of the land, instead the mold bolt can be shifted to other side and the plowing can be continued, so that furrow slices will informally fall in same direction. Sixth primary tillage implement is disc plow. In the disc plow, the shear, the mold bolt and coulter of the mold bolt plow are replaced by an inclined concave steel disc of 60 to 90 cm diameter set at an angle to the direction of travel. Each disc revolves on an axle and the angle of the disc to the vertical position and to the furrow wall is adjustable. Lever arrangements are provided to lift the disc clear of the ground and for changing the angle of molding and adjusting the depth of penetration of the disc into the soil. While working, the discs rotate, scoop out furrows, invert the furrow slice, and pulverize them thoroughly. Disc plow is especially useful under the these following soil conditions, like soil with hard pan and sticky soil, dry hard ground, rough and stony ground, plowing weedy lands, lands with stubbles, and need for deep plowing. Seventh primary tillage implement is reversible disc plow. It is constructed in such a way that the disc can be reversed and the soil is thrown on one side. The land and furrow will adjust themselves properly when the plow is reversed. Reversible disc plow saves time taken by the ordinary disc plow. The furrow slices cut at each trip by the reversible disc plow is laid over the previous furrow, thus resulting in a leveled field after plowing. Eighth primary tillage implement is chisel plow or subsoil plow. It is implement used to break down hard pan that exists in the soil due to continuous same type of operation. It consists of a curved chisel C-like tine with 30 cm radius of curvature and 3 cm thickness. It is rigidly held in a frame which is provided with a handle and a shaft pole. The operation of this plow is the same as that of an ordinary plow. It makes a simple vertical cut in the subsoil up to a depth of 45 cm and facilitates the downward movement of water and subsoil drainage. Chiseling becomes necessary in soil with hard impermeable plow pan. Now to study secondary tillage. Implement secondary tillage is the shallow operation performed after the primary tillage. Secondary tillage implements are used for breaking clods and producing a loose, friable, smooth state. These implements are used with the following objectives. First, to breaking the furrow slice and working the soil to get the required tilth. Second is destruction of weeds. Third is stirring the soil and forming mulch. Fourth, mixing the manures and fertilizers with soil. And fifth, covering the seeds. First secondary tillage implement is cultivators. These implements have number of tines for piercing the soil and breaking clods. Tines of 23 to 30 cm long are fixed to a heavy and sturdy frame mounted on wheels. These tines penetrate up to a depth of 20 cm in heavy models. Cultivators are used when the soil is plowed deep with heavy mold-walled plow to break the big clods that are formed. Second is rotavator. A rotavator is a useful piece of machinery when it comes to soil preparation. The versatile pieces of farming equipment is a motorized machine which uses rotating blades to turn soil. In their essence, rotavators are earth turning equipment which perform a similar function to cultivators and tillers. Third secondary tillage implements are harrows. They are smaller implements with many tines like cultivators, used for breaking smaller clods left unbroken by cultivators and for producing a powdery seed bed. Tines are set closer 5 to 8 cm and are smaller in size. They penetrate up to about 10 cm depth, and these harrows are of different types. First one is a spike tooth harrow. Peg-like steel tines of round, oval, square, triangular or rhomboid sections are fixed on a rigid or flexible frame for use under different soil conditions. Rhomboid section offers a straight cutting edge and it enters the soil properly and is better than others. In undulating lands, the flexible type adjust themselves to the uneven surface. When the frame is of a zigzag type, it is called zigzag harrow. And second type of harrow is a spring tine harrow. Instead of rigid tines, a strong steel springs shaped like the letter C are attached to the frame. Depth of penetration is adjusted with lever arrangement. Tines ride over rocky and other obstructions in the fields and are not damaged since the spring tines recoil on obstruction. Due to vibration, they pulverize clouds better than rigid types. Third type of harrow is chain harrow. Number of stout steel links is connected together to spread over the soil like a mat. Links may have spike-like projections. Since they are flexible, they adjust unevenness of the surface. These harrows are used for breaking clods and making the surface smooth and even. It can also be used for covering seeds after broadcasting. And fourth type of harrow, disc harrow. These harrows are made up of number of concave discs of 46 to 56 cm in diameter, fitted 15 cm apart on square axles. Two sets of discs are mounted on different axles. Discs cut through the soil and effectively pulverize clods. Small animals drawn harrows have 6 discs and power driven harrows have larger numbers. And fifth type of harrows are intercultivating harrow. Different types of harrows are used for intercultivation. Time pass through the inter-row spaces and effectively remove the weeds. The typical example of the intercultivating harrow is junior hoe. Sixth type of harrow is blade harrow. Different from conventional harrow in that there are no tines but they are fixed with horizontal blades which enters into the soil and travel below the surface at a constant depth. These blades severe cut the surface layer from the soil below and leaves it in its original position with slight disturbance to the surface soil. These harrows cut the weeds, eradicate all weeds except those which have underground bulbs. Third, tillage implements are intercultural implements. Out of this, there are different implements about which we will discuss here. First one is Japanese rotary beater. It consists of two small toothed roller or drums mounted on a frame provided with handle. Each roller consists of about 5 toothed blades. This implement while working is pushed and pulled alternatively by the operator in between rows of rice crop. The float provided will guide the implements smoothly while working and prevent the implements sinking into the puddle. The weeder is used to bury the weeds into the mud so as to decompose them add organic matter to the soil sufficient for working this implement. Second implement is cone weeder. It is also similar to rotary weeder in which instead of two toothed roller or drums, two toothed cones are mounted on a frame provided with handle. This implement while working is pushed and pulled alternatively by the operation in between rows of rice crop. The float provided will guide the implements smoothly while working and prevent the implement from sinking. Third secondary tillage implement is long handled weeders. Long handled weeders are used for weeding in row crops for removing shallow rooted weeds. Useful in dry land and garden lands crops when the soil moisture content is 8 to 10%. They are manually operated. One man labor covers nearly 0.05 hectare per day of weeding. And these weeders are of different types, like first one is pegtooth type and second is a star wheel type. Fourth type of tillage implement is a special purpose implements. Implements that are used for a specific purpose other than primary or secondary and intercultural tillage are called as a special purpose implements. These are of various types about which we will discuss here. First one is multi-purpose toolbar and carrier. The multi-purpose tool carrier is used for primary, secondary and intercultural operations, forming bunds, ridges and furrows and for sowing crops in rows. It is suitable for all soils. The spacing between rows is adjustable. Second type of special purpose implements are land leveling implements. This is also of different types, like first one is buck scraper, second is leveling board. Leveling board is used for leveling rice fields after the final plowing to facilitate uniform seed germination. And third is wooden float. It is a bullock drawn implement with a long sledge like drag used for land smothering. By working the field with wooden flat 3 or 4 times lengthwise, crosswise and diagonally, the field is smoothened in a better way. Third type of special purpose implements are land shaping implements, which is of different kinds, like first one is ridge plow, second is bund former. Third type of land shaping implement is bed furrow former, and fourth type is rollers, which are also of different types, like in iron rollers, stone rollers and sheep foot rollers. Fourth type of special purpose implements are sowing implements. Under sowing implements, there are various implements. Like first one is country seed drill or gorru. It consists of a horizontal beam on which a number of tines are fixed at suitable distances. The tine is like the body of the common wooden plough, but is much smaller. It has a vertical hole a little above the point of penetration into the soil. Seeds are released from the above placed seed hopper steadily, few seeds at a time. The base of the hopper has as many holes as there are tines in gorru, and narrow bamboos or metal tubes connect to the hopper and the tines. This enables the seed released in the hopper being dropped in the furrows opened by the tines. The hoppers and the seed tubes are held in position with thin ropes. Second type of sowing implements are mechanized seed drills, which are of different types. Like first one is block drawn seed drill, second is tractor drawn seed drill, and third is rice drum seeder for wetlands where direct rice is sown. Fifth type of tillage implements are implements for wetlands. Under wetland system, the land is prepared by puddling for planting wet rice. Puddling means mechanical manipulation of saturated soils with the standing water in the field. Actually, the structure of the soil is destroyed under puddling. The optimum depth of puddling is about 10 cm in the clay and clay loam types of soils. Good puddling or neatly plowed means the soil should be soft, uniformly leveled, without weeds or stubbles, and with minimum percolation. Why puddling is done? The objectives are described as below. To obtain a soft seed bed for the seedling to establish faster. To minimize percolation of water so that water can stagnate in the field. To minimize leaching loss of nutrients and thereby increase the availability of plant nutrients. To facilitate better availability of nutrients by achieving reduced soil condition. And to incorporate the weeds and stubbles into the soil and to minimize the weed problems. The implements which are used for puddling in wet soils are country plow, boss plow, wetland puddler, cage wheels, sheep foot roller, and helical bladed puddler. Now we'll study about wetland puddler. It consists of three angular bladed cast iron hoods rigidly fixed to a hollow horizontal pipe and is rotated when dragged by a pair of blocks. This implement is proved to be an economic, labor-saving, and an effective dual-purpose implement useful for puddling and trampling green leaf manure in the puddle fields. When used for trampling, the vegetative matter is cut and buried in the soil. It covers around area of 0.8 hectares per day. Now, cage wheels. It is used for puddling in medium and heavy clay soils in wetlands for rice cultivation. The cage wheels are attached in place of pneumatic wheels in power tiller and tractor. The cage wheels perform well in all fields except in fields with clay and silt content of the soil was more than 56%. It saves cost, time, and brings more uniformity and thoroughness in the puddle field than country plowing. Cage wheels attached to power tiller covers an area of 0.44 hectares per day. The average depth of puddle is 23 cm. Now, helical bladed puddler. It is used to puddle the wetland soils after initial plowing with country plow or mallure plow. It is a block drawn implement. Five numbers of helical blades made of mild steels are fixed in a skewed shape and mounted on a wooden frame having wooden bearing such that the blades can rotate freely. A handle and pole shafts are provided. Due to the helical shape of the blade, there will be continuous contact between the blades and the soil, which gives uniform lead on the neck of the blocks. After plowing the land with country plow, the implement can be used to puddle the soil up to a depth of 10 cm. The helical geometry facilitates better churning and slicing of the soil required for puddling, and it covers around 0.6 hectares per day. So this presentation was all about tillage implements. Hope this presentation will be very useful to all of you. I have given here my YouTube channel details, Journey with Vijay Kumar Shrivastav. Having request, please visit the channel, subscribe it, and provide your kind and valuable feedback for further improvements. Thank you.